One of the most common complaints in adrenal fatigue and symptoms of adrenal fatigue is the need to have food in order to avoid fatigue, anxiety, a brain fog soon after a meal is taken. This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com, and in this video, we will go through the mechanics of what actually happens in this form of hypoglycemia, which we call reactive hypoglycemia. Laboratory tests, if you take a spot blood sample, at the time the sensations comes on of fatigue, brain fog, anxiety is usually normal. So sufferers are universally baffled. Doctors are also not sure what is going on and tell the clients or the patients that everything is fine. But is it really fine? Let's take a look. Now, when a blood sugar is dropping, then the term hypoglycemia is used. Usually, clinically, we see the laboratory value of sugar less than 60 to 70 milligram per deciliter. But in the case of adrenal fatigue-associated hypoglycemic episodes, the blood sugar actually is normal. Now, we don't exactly know why this is happening. What we do know is that there's a form of reactive hypoglycemia. A form of hypoglycemia that's called reactive hypoglycemia, I should be more clear, is that it's not the absolute level of blood sugar that decides whether you have symptoms or not. However, it is the drop of normal blood sugar, let's say 100 to 120 milligrams per deciliter, to the 60 or 70 or even 80. So while you can have a spot sugar of 80 and consider normal, but the drop from 110 to 80 is what triggers the hypoglycemic symptoms. This is why it's called reactive hypoglycemia. And when you have this, which is commonly associated with adrenal fatigue, laboratory tests will show normal. Now, what you can do is to eat a bit more frequently, and that is the common thing to do. But you also want to not just simply eat, but understand the physiology that this is the way the body is telling you that it is metabolically deranged underneath. You're not necessarily in a diabetic situation, and you're not necessarily having the medical clinical diagnosis of hypoglycemia, but you have hypoglycemic symptoms, and laboratory values are normal. Now, take more snacks is a good thing to do. Repeat blood tests is usually not productive, but reactive hypoglycemia is a sign of later stages of adrenal fatigue. And usually, when that happens to you, it's a sign that you have to look and see what else is going on. Usually, it's also accompanied by brain fog, irritability, and at nighttime, it can actually wake you up after you've been sleeping. During the daytime, after lunch, you may have to find that you need a snack about 2 hours before. Afterwards, I'm sorry, otherwise you would feel draggy and really fatigued and slumpy. The same thing may happen in the morning around 10 o'clock, about 2 to 3 hours before, I'm sorry, after breakfast, but before lunch, you will then feel a sense that you really need food. And if you don't have that food supply or the sugar boost, then your body will feel very, very weak. These are the classic signs of reactive hypoglycemia in the situation of adrenal fatigue. Now, it's very important also to check with your doctor to see if there are other forms of metabolic imbalances. Those people who have a family history of diabetes, especially, should be a little bit more careful because your body can react in different ways under those situations. But if you really put the picture together clinically, in adrenal fatigue, you can sense the big picture. And the big picture is what counts. It's not just the hypoglycemic episode on its own. Sometimes you can have accompanied, as I said earlier, brain fog, heart palpitations, pain of unknown origin, insomnia, heart palpitations and arrhythmias, joint pains, etc., etc. So knowing this is one of the leads that bring us to adrenal fatigue, and how to overcome this is something that we can deal with once we understand the physiology. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I have written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.